Good morning to all. I hope you all are doing well at your home and keeping yourself healthy. I, Ms. Kunjan Daswani from Shiv Jyoti Educational Group Kota, welcome you all to the e-learning classes of English Grammar. And today we are going to do chapter number 11, 12, 13, 14, that is tenses, simple tenses, continuous tenses and perfect tenses. So, children, please listen to me very carefully because it's a very important topic. It's a very important topic. So, please listen to me very carefully. So, let's see what are tenses. You can open your books to page number 52 for that. So, the tense of the verb tells us whether the action took place in the past, is taking place now in the present, or will take place in the future. So I can say tense jo hota hai beta, jo kaam past mein hua, wo batayega. Jo kaam abhi ho raha hai, ya fir present mein hota hai, that is an habitual action. Aur jo kaam future mein hoga, ye hume batata hai. So in simple words, I can say that tense tells us about time. It tells us about time, like when the action is done and how much the action is done. That is also being told with the help of the tense, that is the verb. How much the work is done. So, in this topic, that is tense, we are going to study about time and work. Okay. So, let's see the examples over here. He played football. Second sentence, he plays football. And third sentence, he will play football. So, in the first sentence, you can see that verb is denoting us the time of the action. That is when the action was done. That is he played. That is the action was done in the past. Usne football khela tha. So, that is the action that is done in the past. In the second sentence, you can see he plays football. Right. So, if I say the verb, that is plays. That is denoting us the action when the action is done, right? So, wo football khelta hai. He plays football. Wo football khelta hai. So, that is what? That is denoting the present tense. So, because the action is done in the present. Wo hota hai. Third sentence. In the third sentence, you can see he will play football. Will play is denoting us what? The time of the action that wo football khelega, that is the future tense. So, the first sentence was of past tense, second was of present tense and the third one was of future tense. Now, as you have seen these topics in the auxiliary verbs, when we studied about verbs and auxiliary verbs, that time you have seen the be form, have form of the verb, that they are used both as a main verb and a helping verb in the sentence, right? So, you can see the be form, that is the be form in the present tense. For the present tense, we will be using is, am or are, and be form in the past tense. For the past tense, we will be using was and were. Have form, that is the have form for present tense, that is has and have. So, for present tense, when we are talking about the present tense, that time we will be using has and have. And when I talk about the past tense of the have form of the verb, that is had. Okay. So, let's see some of the examples. So, I am telling you the example of what? The be form of the verb. For example, if I write he is fond of playing cricket. So you can see over here the subject, that is he. Okay, the subject is he over here. So with he, she or it, that is the singular subject, we will be using is in the present tense. And with he, she, it and it in the past tense, we will be using was. But if I change the subject over here, if I change the subject to I, then what will be the sentence? I am fond of playing cricket. Right? This would be the sentence. So remember one thing, that I will always come with am. Okay, remember this thing, that I will always come with am. Okay, but if I talk about the plural subject, that is if I say the subject is we or they, then that time what you will use, that is if I change the subject over here to what? To they. So they are fond of playing cricket, right? They are fond of playing cricket. So the subject here is plural now, and what we are using with it? Are. Okay, remember this thing, that these are what? These are the be forms of the verb. And this one also, that are, is and am are be forms of the verb. Now see, let's see some examples of be over here. That is, the weather was terrible. So was is denoting what? The past tense, right? In the second sentence you can see, she is reading a book. So is denoting what? The present tense over here. Now let's see the examples of have. She has quite dark hair. So has over here is denoting what? Which tense over here? Present tense. In the second sentence you can see, we had paid the rent in advance. So had over here is denoting what? The past tense. So let's see some more examples related to the have form of the verb. Now we will be going to see the some examples related to the have form of the verb. So if I use the subject he, she or it, let's see, he, she, with this what I will use, I am writing a sentence over here. He or she has a pet dog. So remember one thing, when the subject is in singular, that is he, she or it, that time we will be using has. Okay, remember one thing. But if I change the subject to the plural, that is if I change he or she, in the place of he or she I put they, so what would be the sentence? So they have a pet dog. Okay, so they have a pet dog. Here you can see the subject is in plural. So with that, what we use? The have form of the verb. What is coming? Have is coming over here. Now, if I talk about I, in the be form, we use I with am, right? But when I talk about the have form, what will come with I? Though it is singular, but with singular, that is I is singular, we will be using have with it. So I can say I can be replaced with they, but this but what will come? The have form of the verb will remain same. I have a pet dog. So remember one thing, in the be form of the verb we will be using I with am, but in the have form of the verb we will be using I with have. Okay, so now these were the be form and the have forms of the verb. Now we will see how will and shall is used. This you also have seen in the auxiliary verbs chapter, that was chapter number 9. So shall is used with first person I. It is also used to express command for second and third person. Shall is used to indicate promise and obligation, while will shows determination and promise. So remember one thing, with the first person we will be using I, and that is I, that is what a first person, and with I what we will be using is shall. Okay, remember this thing. And when with the second and the third person, when we are expressing a command, that time we will be using what? Shall. Okay, and it is also used to indicate a promise or obligation, that is when you are showing some duty, that time also you will use what? Shall. But will is used to show what? Determination, when you are determined to do something, that ye to mujhe karna hi hai, to us time hum kiska use karenge? Will ka use karenge. And when we are showing promise also, that time also we will use will. Okay, let's see some examples that are written over here. I shall be late. So as I told you, with I what will come? Shall, because I is what? First person. You all have studied pronouns, you all know what is a first person, what is the second person, and what is a third person. So in the second sentence you can see they will not have enough food. So this sentence is showing what? The determination. So let's see some more examples related to it. So now I am writing the examples for the shall. Okay, so let's see. I shall leave for Mumbai tomorrow. So this is the sentence that is starting with what? I, which is what? A first person, right? This is what? A first person, and with it what we used? Shall, right? Because it is denoting what? A future action. But how will is used? Now with will, what I can say? That we will go there. Whatever happens. So this is showing what? The determination. Ki hum waha jayenge hi sahi, kuch bhi ho jaye. That is, we is coming, and what I use? Will I use to show what? To show the determination. Ki hum waha jayenge, bale kuch bhi ho jaye. Theek hai? So I hope I am clear with will and shall now. So this was your chapter number 11. Now we are going to start with chapter number 12, that is simple tenses. For this chapter, you can open your books to page number 55. So, in this chapter, we are going to study about simple present tense, simple past tense and simple future tense. So, first we will be studying what? Simple present tense. So, what is the simple present tense and how it is used? So, the simple present tense is formed with the base form of the verb, that is V1. I can say the base form or the root form, that is we are denoting it with V1. We use simple present tense to indicate that an event or action is going on at the time of speaking and may continue for an indefinite period of time. So, if I can say like that कि ये जो action है जो हम बोल रहे हैं उस time पे हो रहा होगा, ठीक है? या ये कुछ ऐसे indefinite period, मतलब यहाँ पे indefinite क्यों use हुआ है? Why we are using indefinite over here? Because we are not sure कि वो चीज कब तक रहने वाली है. So that is why we are using indefinite. So in the second point you can see it is used to indicate that the situation is permanent. जब कोई situation permanent है, that time also we will be using simple present tense. Third, to express habitual actions and general truths. So when you are showing some habits or some general facts, that time also we will be using simple present tense. Fourth, to give instructions on how to do something. If I am instructing you related to something, that put these pencils in your box. So that is what an instruction. So we use what? Simple present tense. We use the base form of the verb, that was put, right? So let's see some examples related to it. Some examples are, he speaks English. So here you can see that is what? That is showing what? That is showing the habitual action. Okay. In the second sentence, he cleans the car. So this is also we are using what? The base form of the verb, right? Third, my grandparents live in Gujarat. That is showing what? Ki that's an indefinite period of time. Wo abhi to reh rahe hain, but hame kya pata kab tak rahenge, right? So that time also we use simple present tense and the base form of the verb. Fourth, the train leaves every morning at 8 a.m. So that is what? That is showing the permanent, the situation that is permanent, that the train leaves every morning at 8 a.m. So I am going to give you some more examples related to it, but first we will be going to see the structure of it. So if you want, you can write this structure in front of that topic, that is simple present tense, given on page number 55. So here now we are going to see the structure for simple present tense. Let's see what is the structure. Subject plus first form of the verb, that is the base form of the verb, plus S or E S. When we are talking about the main verb, the directly the main verb, that time either we will use S or E S with it. Okay. After that, the rest of the sentence, right? The rest of the sentence. So we will go with this structure only. So I am going to write a sentence and we are going to see what is the subject, what is the first form, and with this we are using the S or ES form of the verb. So this thing, that is the structure, that's the formula for simple present tense. Like in maths you have formulas, so in tenses we are going to work with these formulas. Okay, so I'm going to write a sentence. Look over here. He wakes up at 6 a.m. Right? He wakes up at 6 a.m. So, what is the subject? First, the subject is coming. Right? The subject is he over here. After that, we are using the first form of the verb. You can see wait is the first form, and with this we are using what? S. You can see over here we are using S with it, right? He wakes up at 6 a.m. and then what is coming? The rest of the sentence. So this is the structure for simple present tense. Okay, now we are going to study about simple past tense. So let's see how it is formed. The simple past tense is formed with the past form of the verb, that is V2, and we can say V2 is what? The past form of the verb. So it is denoted by V2, that is the second form of the verb. We use simple past tense to express actions that were completed at a time before now and in the past. So when we have to express the actions that were completed before, so that for that we will be using simple past tense. When an action took place at a definite time, but the exact time is not known, we know that the action is going to take place, it's being took place at this time, but not the exact time. So that time also we will be using simple past tense. To show habitual actions that existed in the past but do not happen now. So like some habit you were having in the past but now you are not continuing it, that time also what we will be using? Simple past tense. So let's see some examples for simple past tense. I solved the puzzle. So solved is denoting what? The second form of the verb. In the second sentence, we crossed the channel yesterday. So here we are talking about the action that was done before that. So crossed is denoting what? The second form of the verb, and it is a simple past tense. She played the piano when she was a child. When you are denoting the action of the past that you did in the past but you are not doing it now, right now. Some habit that you do in the, that you did in the past but you are not doing it right now, that that also is denoted to you when we are using what? Simple past tense. Fourth, we didn't have any money. So didn't is showing what? The second form of the verb, and we use second form in simple past tense. Fifth, when did they go to Dubai? So that's a question being asked. So did this used to ask question in simple past tense. So let's see its structure and understand it more precisely. You can see the structure is already written over here. Subject plus we second, that is the second form of the verb, or I can say the past form of the verb, and the rest of the sentence. So I am going to write an example, one more examples related to simple past tense. So just look over here and we are going to relate it with this structure, and you can write the structure in front of the topic, that is simple past tense. So I am going to write that sentence that we did in the simple present. I am going to just convert the sentence into simple past tense according to this rule. So we have taken, he wakes up at 6 a.m. So I am going to change it. So the wakes was the first form of the verb. Now I am going to use the second form of the verb, that is woke. He woke up at 6 a.m. Okay. So here this is what? The subject, second form of the verb, and then the rest of the sentence, right? Now if I am going to ask you a question in these kind of sentences where we are using the second form of the verb, you will be using did with it. Okay, now understood? Now we are going to see the simple future tense. The simple future tense is formed with will plus V1. We use simple future tense to show an action that is going to take place in the future, to make predictions about what is likely to happen. Third, to make promises or offers. Or fourth, it's used with will to show willingness or wish. So I can say that simple future tense is formed with will and the first form of the verb, that is the base form of the verb, but it will come with will. Now we use simple future tense to show that is that an action is going to take place in the future. Jo ab future mein hone wala hai, wo actions hum simple future tense mein batayenge. Second, to make prediction. जब हम कोई कुछ चीज़ predict करते हैं, that we are predicting that this is going to happen, that time also we will be using simple future tense. When we are making a promise, or when we are offering something, or when we are showing willingness or wish, that time also we will be using simple future tense. So let's see some examples related to it. Some examples related to simple future tenses. We will arrive in the meeting. So will arrive is coming will with the first form of the verb, and in this sentence we are showing the future, an action that is going to take place in the future. Second, Ellen will complete her first novel this October. So now we know that we are predicting something, that her first novel will be completed by the October. Third, they will bake pies in the evening. So will is coming with the first form of the verb, and it's denoting what? Simple future tense. Now let's see the rule for simple future tense. So this is the structure for simple future tense. So we are going to convert the sentence that we have taken in the simple present and simple past. So that sentence only we are going to convert in simple future tense. So he will wake up at 8 a.m. Okay, so he is the subject over here. Then we are using will, because either will or shall we have to use. So we are using will, and then wake, that is the first form of the verb, that is the base form of the verb, and then what is coming, the rest of the sentence. So this is the structure for simple future tense. You can write it in front of the topic in your book. Now we are going to see one more topic, that is going to. What does this going to represent? We use going to when we talk about future plans and arrangement. When you have a future plan, or when you have planned something for the future, you have arranged something for the future, that time also we will be using going to. So you can see the structure that is written over here: subject plus is, am, are plus going to plus verb first form plus rest of the sentence. So I can say is going to, am going to, or are going to. Examples are written over here. Let's see the examples. I am going to learn a new language. So we are using what? We are planning something for the future. So that is why we use going to. So I, with I we are using am, and am going to. Second, Ajay is going to read that book. So we are showing what? We are showing the future plans. That is why we are using going to. Okay, so that is the use of going to predict the future plans and arrangements. So one more thing that we have to see over here, that with he, she, and it, we will be using is. So is going to, I can say, right, with I we will be using am going to, right, and with we and they, we will be using are going to. Okay, so with he, she, and it is going to. with I am going to, and with we and they we are using are going to. Okay. Now we are going to study about continuous tenses. This is your chapter number 13. So in this chapter we are going to see present continuous tense, past continuous tense and future continuous tense. So let's see what are these continuous tense. So first we are going to study about present continuous tense. We form the present continuous tense with is, am or are and the present participle form of the verb. The structure for these are written over here: is, am, are plus verb first form plus ing, that is for positive sentence. Then the sentence is in its affirmative form. Is, am, are plus not plus V1, that is the base form of the verb, plus ing. So not we are adding over here to show, to make the negative sentence. So note this thing: continuous tenses are also called progressive tenses because of the use of ing form of the verb, which indicates ongoing actions. सो प्रेजेंट कंटीन्यूअस टेंस में हम वो एक्शंस शो करते हैं, सारे कंटीन्यूअस टेंसेस जो भी हम पढ़ेंगे, जो काम चल रहा है, ऑनगोइंग एक्शंस हम बताते हैं. दैट इज व्हाई वी कैन आल्सो कॉल कंटीन्यूअस टेंसेस एज प्रोग्रेसिव टेंसेस. सो आई कैन से प्रेजेंट प्रोग्रेसिव टेंस आल्सो, राइट? लेट्स सी द एग्जांपल्स ऑफ प्रेजेंट कंटीन्यूअस एंड लेट्स सी, फर्स्ट वी विल बी सीइंग इट्स यूजेस एंड देन वी विल सी इट्स एग्जांपल्स. सो वी यूज प्रेजेंट कंटीन्यूअस टेंस to indicate actions that are happening at the time of speaking. Let's suppose if I am teaching, okay, so I can say I am teaching tenses, okay. So this is the thing I am doing right now at the time of speaking. That is only we have that actions we are going to in the use to express what, to show present continuous tense. Second, for some action that are happening before and after a given point of time. So when the actions are happening before and after a given point of time, to show that we are using present continuous tense. To show something which is temporary, changing or developing. When something can change, ki haan ye cheez baad mein badal sakti hai, theek hai, it's not permanent, that's a temporary thing. So that for showing that we will be using present continuous tense. To show something that is planned or arranged for the future. जब हमें बताना है कि कुछ चीज़ें planned हैं या फिर arrange कर रखी हैं future के लिए, for that time also we will be using present continuous tense to show repeated actions. Repeated actions बताने के लिए भी, जो काम होता रहता है, बार बार होता है, उसके लिए भी हम present continuous tense का use करेंगे. So let's see the examples of present continuous tense. They are reading books. You can see are, is, am, are, we have seen in present continuous tense that what we will be using is, am or are. So the subject is plural, so we used are. They are reading book. Read, V1 plus ing, so reading books. He is constantly talking. Here I am showing what? The repeated action. कि वो constantly क्या कर रहा है? बातें कर रहा है. ठीक है, तो मतलब वो ये रिपीटेड एक्शन है. दैट इज व्हाई आई टोल्ड यू फॉर रिपीटेड एक्शंस वी विल बी यूजिंग प्रेजेंट कंटीन्यूअस टेंस. आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू द पार्टी टुनाइट, सो आई एम यूजिंग आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू. दैट्स अ नेगेटिव सेंटेंस वी फॉर्मड ओवर हियर. ही इज मीटिंग सम ऑफ हिज फ्रेंड्स टुडे, सो दैट इज व्हाट, दैट इज हिज फ्यूचर प्लान्स. सो व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द अरेंज्ड ऑफ फ्यूचर प्लान, व्हेन वी आर प्लान समथिंग for the future, so that time also we will be using present continuous tense. So let's see the structure in detail and you can write. So this is the structure for present continuous tense. You can see subject plus is, am or are plus verb first form, that is the root form or the base form of the verb, plus ing plus rest of the sentence. So I can say I am giving you an example. He then is singing a song. So you can see he is what? The subject over here, right? And is, am, are, we have to choose among is, am and are. With the singular subject we will be using is, with the plural subject we will be using are, and you all know I will always come with am. So with I we will always use am, okay? So this is the structure for present continuous tense, and you can write it in your book in front of the topic, that is present continuous tense. Now we are going to study past continuous tense. So let's see, the past continuous tense describe actions or events taking place at a particular point of time in the past. So past continuous tense tells us about the action that was going on at the particular point of time in the past. So we form the past continuous tense with was or were plus first form of the verb, that is the root form of the verb, plus ing. We use past continuous tense to talk about an unfinished action that was interrupted by another action. The unfinished action takes the past continuous form, while the second action is in the simple past tense. So we are, when we talk about an unfinished action that is not yet completed, so, and we are interrupting the sentence with the other with the another action done by the subject. So that time the unfinished action will represent the past continuous tense, and while the second action that is being interrupted, that we have interrupted by another action, right? So the second action will be represented by the simple past tense. When two actions take place at the same time in the past and continue for the same duration of time, while is mostly used in such sentences. So when two actions are taking place at the same point of time only and in the past, and that, and they're continuing for that same duration, so that time also we will be using past continuous tense. And mostly in these type of sentences we will be acknowledging while over there. There will be while, always there will be while in these kind of sentences. To show that something continued for some time in the past, when we have to show something that this thing continued in the past for some duration of time, so that time also we will be using past continuous tense. Some examples are given to us over here. We were watching TV when she called us. So there was an unfinished action, and it is interrupted by the another action, right? So you can see this, in this type of sentence also we are using what? Which type of tense? Past continuous tense. You can see were, watching is coming, were is used in past continuous tense with the first form of the verb plus ing. Second, I was studying while he was making dinner. So we are continuing, we are doing the same we are doing the two actions at the same point of time. That time we will be using past continuous tense, and I told you when we talk about the actions that are being continued at the same duration of time, so that time we use, in these type of sentences we use what? We use while. So that is why we are having what? Past continuous tense over here. So was studying is in which form? The past continuous form of the verb. Third sentence, Tina was doing her work when her uncle came home. So you can see we can say that this action was unfinished, that was an unfinished action, and in between that action some another action took place that interrupted that unfinished action. So two actions are going to take place are taking place in this sentence. So in this sentence we can acknowledge the rule of past continuous tense. Okay, let's look at the structure for past continuous tense. You can write this structure in the past continuous tense, in front of the past continuous tense in your book. So you can open your books and write the structure for past continuous tense. So the structure for past continuous tense is subject plus was or were plus one plus ing plus rest of the sentence. Rest of the sentence. So I am going to give you an example to relate with this structure. So first we will be writing the subject, that is he, then was or were. With singular we will be using was, with singular okay, and with plural we will be using were. Okay, so with plural we will be using were and with singular we will be using was. Okay, so I am going to write the subject. I have already written the subject, that is he. He is a singular subject, so with singular we will be using was. So he was, then first form of the verb, that is sing, and then I will add ing, then the rest of the sentence. So he was singing a song. So you can see if I change the subject to they, then what will be coming in place of was? Were will come. So they were singing a song. So the sentence will be changed according to the subject. Okay. Now let's see the future continuous tense. So the future continuous tense is formed with will plus be plus verb first form plus ing. So when we have to form the future continuous tense, we will be using will plus be plus first form of the verb plus ing. So you can see we use future continuous tense to talk about events that will be happening at some point in the time in the future. So when we have to talk about the at events that are going to that will be happening in the future at some point of time, that to show that events, we will be using future continuous tense. Second, to indicate a future action which we expect to happen as a part of routine, that we are expecting some actions that we are expecting that they are our routine actions. So to show that kind of actions, some that kind of future actions, so we will be using future continuous tense for it. Third, to predict an outcome. When we predict a result related to something, when we are predicting the outcome of that thing, so that time also we will be using future continuous tense. So let's see the examples related to it. I will be writing articles on different topics. So that is the future action that is going to happen in the future in some point of time. That is why will be writing. That is the structure for future continuous tense. They will be playing hockey in that field on Thursday. So that is what, that's some routine action, that routine future action that is going to take place. That is why we are using the future continuous tense in this sentence. My mother will be helping me to do the task. So this also is representing the future continuous tense. So let's know the structure for future continuous tense. Children, you can write the structure in front of the topic given in your book. So the structure for future continuous tense is, first subject will come, after that will, then be, then verb first form, then ing and then the rest of the sentence, right? So this is the structure for future continuous tense. So look, please look at the example very carefully, because I am going to run according to the structure only. First the subject, that is he. We are going to change that sentence only that we used for past continuous and present continuous tense. That sentence we are going to convert into future continuous tense according to this structure. So he, then what we will be using? Will. Then after will, what will come? Be. So he will be singing a song. So what structure I use? Future continuous tense with the subject, then will, then be, and then the verb first form, and then what is there? ing, and then the rest of the sentence. So this is the structure for future continuous tense. So this was chapter number 13. Now we are going to start with chapter number 14, that is perfect tenses. Perfect, what does this perfect states us? Perfect tells us the complete action, the finished action, right? So here also we are going to study about the three tenses, that is the present perfect tense, past perfect tense, and then the future perfect tense. So let's look at the, we will be first studying about the present perfect tense. The present perfect tense is formed with has or have plus third form, that is the past participle form of the verb. So this is how we will be forming the present perfect tense. It is used for an action that started in the past and continued in the present. So it is used for an action that has been started in the past and was completed in the present. Second, and repeated action between the past and now, as something that is repeated once again. So that is time, that time also we will be using future present perfect tense. Third, an action where the time is not important. When we are representing the action where time is not much important, that time also we will be using present perfect tense. An action that has just been completed. As you all know, in the perfect tense, we will be talking about the actions that are completed, the finished actions, right? Perfect means the finished actions only. We will be talking about that actions, and an action that has just been completed, that is used to form what? Present perfect tense. So let's see some examples. We have gone to beach many times. So this is what? This is the repeated action. Once again, in the past also, and in the now also you are going, in the past also you have gone. So we have gone to beach many times. Second sentence, she has lost her wedding ring. So that is what? That is just the action that has just been done, that has just been completed, that has just been happened. So she has lost her wedding ring is representing what? Present perfect tense. Third, I have just finished my internship at the museum. So this sentence also is representing the action that has just happened, and or I can say just completed. I have lived in the United States since 2005. So that was the action that was being done from the past and is continuing till now. So that is, for that also we are representing the present perfect tense. So now we are going to see the structure related to the present perfect tense. Children, you can write the structure for present continuous tense in front of the present perfect tense in front of the topic. Now this is the structure for present perfect tense. You can see subject, then has or have. Then has or have will depend on the subject. Now with the singular subject we will be using has, with the plural subject we will be using have, but there is an exception, that is I. With I we will always use have, though it is singular, but with that we will be using has. Okay, then what will come, the third form of the verb. You can see the third form of the verb is there. We will be using the third form, or I can say the past participle form of the verb, whether it is in the present perfect tense or it is in the past perfect tense. We will be using what? The third form of the verb. And then what will come? The rest of the sentence. For example, the sentence is written over here. You can see what is there? I is what? The subject. Then have is coming, because with I what will come? Have will come. Then the third form of, that's the third form of eat. The third form of eat is eaten. So I have eaten lunch. So this is the example for present perfect tense. Now we are going to study past perfect tense. So the past perfect tense is formed with had plus third form of the verb, that is the past participle form of the verb. The past perfect tense is used to indicate that one action was completed before another began. So the past perfect tense is used to indicate that action, that this action was completed when the another action started, when the another action began. So for that action that was completed, for that we will be showing the past perfect tense. We use past perfect tense for the earlier action, that the action that was completed, for that we will be using the past perfect tense. And for the second action we will be using that has just begun, for that action we will be using the simple past tense. As you can see the example over here, after Sophie had finished her work, she went to lunch. So you can see this action is completed, and after completing this action, the second action had took place. The second action had just begun. So for the first action that was completed, we will be using past perfect tense, and after that what are we using? Simple past tense. So let's see the structure for past perfect tense now. We just have to change one thing over here. We just have to change one thing, that is in place of has or have, what we will be putting is had. Okay, then the example will just change over here. What will be the example? In place of have, what I will be using? Had. Because we are running according to the structure of past perfect tense, right? So in place of this we will be using had. So I had eaten lunch. Okay, this is the according to the structure of past perfect tense. Now we are going to see future perfect tense. So the future perfect tense is formed with will plus have plus third form of the verb. After will what will come? Have, and then what? The third form of the verb. We use future perfect tense to show an action that has not yet happened but will be completed before a particular point of time in the future. So I can say we are representing that actions that are going to happen in the future, and we know that at this particular point of time that action will be completed, before this particular point of time that action will be completed in the future. So I can say, let's see the example over here. She will have cooked dinner by the time he reached home. So after this action is going to complete, this would have been already done, right? So that is why she will have cooked dinner. I have used what? The rule of future perfect tense, right? So that is why will have is coming with the third form of the verb. So this is the sentence for future perfect tense, and we are running according to this structure. First the subject will come, that is Tina. After Tina, will have, then will have is there. Then the third form of the verb, that is learned, and then the rest of the sentence to play the piano. So this is what, this is the structure for future perfect tense. So we studied about the simple tenses, we studied about the continuous tenses, and we studied about the perfect tenses. So we have in short covered the 9 tenses, that is simple present, simple past, simple future, then present continuous, past continuous, future continuous, and then present perfect, past perfect, and future perfect tense. Now we are going to see the bookwork of chapter number 11, then 12, then 13, and then 14. Now we are going to start with the exercise of chapter number. So now let's start with the exercise of chapter number 11. You can open your books to page number 52 for that. So let's see the first exercise, that is fill in the blanks with is, am, are, was, or were to complete these sentences. One has been done for you. So in the first sentence you can see I dash very happy because my friends dash in town. So with I, as I told you, what will come, that is am, and this sentence is in present tense, so that is why we are using am over here. And in the first blank, if it is am, and then you can move forward, you can see because my friends. Now you can see my friends is what, it is in plural noun, so that is why it's in plural, that is why we are using are over there. So now let's see the second sentence, that is Linda dash cheerful by nature. So we'll be understanding it on this board, that is you can see Linda is what, a singular subject, it's a singular subject, right? It's a singular subject, right? And that is why we are using is over here in this blank. So the answer for this sentence is Linda is cheerful by nature. Why we are using is over here, why not was? Because it's showing the habit, that is the fact that Linda's nature is like that only. That is why we are using is over there, because the sentence would be in simple present tense. Now the third sentence, the mother bird dash in the nest to feed her chicks. So once again the subject, that is the mother bird, is once again is in the singular, is the subject is singular over here. That is why also in this blank also what will come is will come, because that's the once again the natural habit, that's the general fact that is there, that she is in the nest to feed her chicks. So that is why is this coming over here. Now rest you have to do in the same way only. Now coming back to exercise number B, that is you can open your books to page number 53 for that. Fill in the blanks with have, has, or had. One has been done for you. So now first sentence is all the friends dash an enjoyable time at the party yesterday. So as I told you that has and have will be used in the present tense and had will be used in the past tense. Has with the singular subject and have with the plural subject, and in the past tense we will be using had. So in this sentence you can see one thing is mentioned, that is yesterday. So this task was done before the time, that was this task was done in the past, that is why we are using had over here. Now let's see the second sentence, dash he ever been to Australia. We are now going to see it on the whiteboard. Now let's see the second sentence, that is dash he ever been to Australia. So you can see what is the subject over here, that is he, and he is what, again a singular subject, that is why with he what will be used, has. So we will be filling this blank with has over here, because it's not being asked in the past, that's the that's been done in the present, that is why we are using has over here. And one more thing, that is the subject is singular over here, that is why we are using has. Now let's see the third sentence, यू डैश कट योर सेल्फ बी मोर केयरफुल. सो यू कैन सी एज आई टोल्ड यू व्हेन आई हैव एक्सप्लेन यू दी हैव हैड एंड हैज दैट टाइम आई टोल्ड यू दैट देर इज एन एक्सेप्शन टू दिस केस दैट इज आई एंड यू विल ऑलवेज कम विद have only, though they are singular but they will be used with have. So what I will write over here, what will be filled in this blank, that is have. So you have cut yourself, be more careful. Now rest you have to do in the same way only. Now please open to page number 54 for the next exercise, that is exercise number C. Fill in the blanks with will or shall. One has been done for you. So the first sentence, the soldiers dash be rewarded for their bravery. So either will come or either shall will come. We have filled this blank with shall because it's a duty. Shall is used to show what? Obligation. So that is an obligation, that is why we are using shall over here. Now let's see the second sentence, that is Henry dash be kept back after school if he does not complete the work. So we'll be seeing this sentence on the whiteboard. So let's see the second sentence, Henry dash be kept after school if he does not complete the work. So you can see this sentence is expressing a command and shall is used to express a command. So this sentence will be filled with shall because we are expressing a command over here. We are commanding something, that is why shall will be used. In the third sentence you can see Uncle Mayank dash arrive on Monday as expected. So this is a promise being made. So what we will be using in the blank, that is will, because will is used to make a promise. Okay, so this was exercise C and rest you have to do in the same way only. Let's move forward to the exercise of chapter number 12, that is simple tenses. You can open your books to page number 56 for that. Let's see the first exercise. That is, rewrite these sentences, correcting the errors in them. One has been done for you. What you have to do is, you have to rewrite the sentence again by correcting the errors, as this sentence is having an error in them and you have to correct it and you have to rewrite the sentence again in the blank. Okay, let's see the first one. The sun set in the west. So as I told you, if the subject is singular, the verb, that is, that if the verb, it is followed by directly a verb, we will add S or ES in it. So what is the correction that we have to make over here is, the sun sets will come, not set, sets will come, the sun sets in the west. So now let's see the second and third exercise on the whiteboard. Now let's see what is the error in the second sentence, that is Nitin go to school every day. So what is the error? Let's see the subject over here. That is, once again the subject is singular over here. So when we came when we come to the verb over here, that is in once again in singular only, that is why we have to change it. This is the error over here. We have to change this verb. What we have to do, we have to put goes in place of go. So what would be the correct sentence? What you have to write in the blank, that is Nitin goes to school every day. This would be the answer for second sentence. Now let's see the third one. My friends and I plays in the park. So you can see, what is the subject? My friends and I, that means the subject is in plural, right? So let's see the verb. Verb once again is having S with it. So when the subject is in plural, then the verb would be in singular. So what we will be putting over there in place of plays, we will change it with play. So this is the error, and what we have to rewrite the sentence again. So what would be the answer? My friends and I play in the park. So this is the answer for third sentence, and rest you have to do in the same way only. Let's come back to the another exercise, that is exercise number C. What you have to do, fill in the blanks with simple past form of the verbs in bracket, and one has been done for you. The verbs are given in the bracket and you have to make it in the simple past tense form. So let's see the first one. Meeta dash swimming during the summer months. So what is the verb which is given to us? That is enjoy. And as we know, the rule for simple past form, that is subject plus verb second form plus rest of the sentence, right? So what we have to put it put over here, the second form of the verb. So the second form of the verb enjoy is enjoyed. So what would be coming in the first blank? That is enjoyed. Now let's see the second sentence. Now let's see the second sentence. The dark clouds dash in the sky, and the verb given to us is gather. Let's see the what is the second form of gather, that is gathered. So what will come in the blank? That is gathered. So this is the answer for second one. Now let's see the third one. The soldiers dash smartly in the parade on Republic Day, and the verb given to us is march. So second form of march, that is the past form of march, is marched. So answer is marched, because we have to put the simple past form of the verb. So that is the past form of the verb. Now rest you have to do in the same way only. Now exercise number D on page number 59. Please open your books to page number 59. Fill in the blanks with the correct form of the verbs in bracket. One has been done for you. So now you have to put the correct form of the verb, and verb is given in the bracket. We have, this is the exercise for simple future tense, and we have to put the correct form of simple future tense. And what was the rule for simple future tense? Will plus we one, that is the base form of the verb, or the past part is or the root form of the verb. So first sentence, our neighbors dash into their new house in January, and the verb given to us was move. So it will come with will plus we one. So move is what? The base form of the verb only. So it will come with will. So our neighbors will move into their new house in January. Now see the, let's see the second sentence. Father dash a new car soon. This we will be seeing on the whiteboard. Second sentence, father dash a new car soon, and the verb given to us is buy. So it will come with the will plus V1 form, right? So V1 is already given to us, and we have to add will before it. So the answer for this one is will buy. Okay, this is the answer for the second one. Now let's see the third one. Ajit and his friends dash watch. Watch is the verb given to us. The final of the cricket tournament. So now it will once again come with will plus V1 form. So what will be the answer for it? Will watch. So this is the answer for third one, and rest you have to do in the same way only. Now let's come to the another exercise, that is the last exercise. That is on page number 60. You can open your books to page number 60. F, choose the correct options to fill in the blanks. One has been done for you. So we are given the options, and we have to put the correct option in the blank. So the first one, the scientists dash the results of their experiment. So this is the sentence which is done in the future. So for A, option is discloses. B is will not disclose. and C is will disclosed. So will disclose is not any kind of form that is used. So will disclose will not come. So either the answer is the A one or B one. So discloses is not the answer, because we are showing the, we are predicting something for the future. That is why the sentence would be of future only. That is why the answer for the first one is B option. That is, the scientists will not disclose the results of their experiment. Now let's see the second sentence. Now let's see the answer for the second one. Who dash you up from school today? And we are given with three options. A is pick, B is are picking, and C is will pick. So you can see that is the action being done in the future. So that the correct answer for this one is the C one. So we will write this this answer in the blank. That is, who will pick you up from school today? So this is the answer for second one, and rest you have to do in the same way only. Now let's come to exercise of chapter number 13, that is continuous tenses. You can open your books to page number 62. So exercise number B, fill in the blanks with simple present or present continuous form of the verbs in bracket. One has been done for you. So one blank is filled already. So let's see what you have to do is, you have to fill in the blanks with either simple present tense or present continuous tense. So the rule for simple present was subject plus a V1, that is the base form of the verb, plus SOES plus rest of the sentence. So that was the rule. So, and present continuous forms structure was subject is am, are, plus V1 plus ing and plus rest of the sentence. So this was the rule for present continuous tense. Now let's see the paragraph over here. First, Vikram feels nervous whenever he dash up on the stage to give a speech. So that is what, that is a habit, that is why feels is coming. And in the second blank also, what will come? Whenever he goes up on the stage to give a speech. So like this you have to fill this paragraph. So rest you have to do in the same way only. Now let's come back to the exercise, next exercise, that is on page number 64. So the exercise, fill in the blank in these sentences with the correct form of the simple past tense or the past continuous form of the verbs in bracket. One has been done for you. So this is what, this is what you have to fill, you have to fill the blank with either a simple past tense or past continuous tense. We already know the rule. So in simple past tense we use the second form of the verb, and in past continuous tense was or were plus V1 plus ing, that is the ing form of the verb. So now let's see. Neeta was walking to the market with Riya and Aarti. In the first blank, walk was the verb given to us, so we filled it with was walking. The three girls dash excitedly as they had not met for a long time. So the, in the second blank what will come? Were talking excitedly as they had not met for a long time. Now please open your books to page number 64 and exercise number D. Fill in the blanks in these sentences with the correct form of the simple past tense or the past continuous tense form of the verbs in brackets. One has been done for you. You have to fill the blank with either simple past tense form or the past continuous form. In simple past tense we use the second form, that is the past form of the verb, and in the past continuous form we use was and was or were plus the ing form of the verb. So let's see. First one, Neeta dashed to the market with Riya and Aarti, and the verb was given to us was walk. So we have to fill this blank with past continuous tense, because that is the ongoing action that was done on the particular period of time in the past. So was walking. So Neeta was walking. Why was is coming? Because Neeta is the subject, which is singular. Sunita is a singular subject. That is why we are using was with the ing form of walk. So was walking is the answer. The three girls dash excitedly as they had not met for a long time. So in the second sentence, we are given with the verb talk. So the answer is, you can see first the subject, that is three girls, that is the subject is plural. So what we will be using, was or were, we will be using were. So three girls were talking excitedly as they had not met for a long time. And you rest you have to do in the same way only. Let's move to the another exercise, that is of chapter, you can open your books to 65, page number 65, exercise number E. Fill in the blanks with simple future tense or the future continuous form of the verbs in bracket, and one has been done for you. So we are given with the verb in the bracket and we have to put either the simple future tense or the future continuous tense form of the verb in the blank. So let's see the first one. Nita dash the role of a queen in the play tomorrow. So this is the action being done in done at the particular period of time in the future. So we will be using future continuous tense over here. So verb is given to us, that is play, and the rule for future continuous was will plus be plus ing form of the verb. So what will come? Will be playing, because the verb was given to us was play. So Nita will be playing the role of a queen in the play tomorrow. We are sure she dash beautiful. So now that is a prediction being made, and for prediction we use simple future tense. So what will be will come in this blank, that is the simple future tense form of look. So answer for this one is, we are sure she will look beautiful. So this is the answer for the second blank, and rest you have to do in the same way only. Now let's move to exercises of chapter number 14, and you have to open your books to page number 67 for that. First one, fill in the blanks with the present perfect tense of the verbs in bracket. One has been done for you. So the first sentence is, the students dash their work, and the verb was given to us was complete, and we have to fill the sentence with present perfect tense. What was the rule for present perfect tense? Has or have plus the third form of the verb. So the first one, the students dash complete. So complete is the verb. We have to use, we have to see the subject over here, that is what, that is a plural subject, and with plural what we use, have, that is why have, and then the third form of complete. So have completed, the students have completed their work. Now let's see the second sentence, the gardener dash buy all the seeds. Now let's see the second sentence, the gardener dash all the seeds, and we are given with the verb buy. We have to use the present perfect tense over here. So what will come, what we will see the subject first. So subject is in singular, so with singular we will be using has. So has and the third form of buy, the third form of buy is bought. So what will come, the gardener has bought all the seeds. Okay, this is the answer for second one. Now let's see the third sentence, mother dash finish her work and is relaxing. We are given with the verb finish, and first we will see the subject. Subject once again is singular, so what we will be using, has, and the third form of finish, that is finished. So mother has finished her work and is relaxing. So this is the answer for third one. Now rest you have to do in the same way only. Now let's move to the another exercise, which is on page number 68, see exercise. Fill in the blanks with simple past, the past continuous or the past perfect form of the verb in bracket. One has been done for you. The first sentence is, Alia dash sleep, she dash tired and weak. So what you have to do is, you have to fill the sentence with the simple past or past continuous or past perfect tense. Simple past tense and simple past tense we use the second form of the verb. In the past continuous tense we use was or were plus ing form of the verb, and in the past perfect form what we use the third form of the verb with had. So let's see, Alia was sleeping, she dash tired and weak. So what will come? The verb is given to us, look, and that was the action that was done in the past. So what we will write? She looked tired and weak. So this is the answer that would be filled in this blank, and rest you have to do in the same way only. Now let's move to the another exercise. Please open your books to page number 69 now. Exercise number E, fill in the blanks with simple future, the future continuous or the future perfect form of the verbs in bracket. One has been done for you. So either you have to fill the blank with simple future or with the future continuous or with future perfect form of the verb. So if it's in simple future, what will come? Will plus the V1 form, that is the base form of the verb. In future continuous, what will come? Will be plus the ing form of the verb. Now in the future perfect, what will come? Will have plus the third form of the verb. So let's see. Karina dash in the inter-school quiz competition next month, and the verb given to us is participate. So what will come? Will participate. What will come? Will participate, because that is the action being done in the future. She and the other three members of her team dash very seriously for this event. So what is the verb given to us? Prepare, because this action is done in the future, will be done in the future, that is why what will come? Will prepare. You have to write will prepare in this sentence. Now this was now rest you have to do in the same way only. Now I hope you have understood the chapter. Please do the exercise which is given to you in the PDF form. Thank you.